habibi halal habibi 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 halal habibi.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أما بعد, welcome to our program. Reminder, this Ramadan, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has counted us amongst those to witness this year's Ramadan. May Allah count it amongst very many still to come in our lives. Today, inshallah, we are going to be talking to ourselves about the topic, you will be tested. You will be tested. And this is because Allah has said so. And he says so in many places in the Quran. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. Alif lam mim. أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا فهم لا يفتنون ولقد فتن الذين من قبلهم فليعلمن الله الذين صدقوا وليعلمن الكاذبين. Allah says in this set of ayah that why do you think that we will leave you untested just because you have claimed to be a believer? وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Indeed, we subjected to trial those who preceded you in faith. Those who were better than you in iman, we subjected them to trial. And then Allah goes on to say why we must go through trial. فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. You must go through trial because it is by way of trial that we are able to separate those who are real believers from those who only claim to believe. And this is the ultimate reason why Allah must subject us to trial, so He can be able to separate the true believers from those who only claim to believe. But mankind, sometimes we think that we are going through trial, but in the wisdom of Allah, something good is actually about to start in our life. And we all remember the very origin of mankind, the story of the beginning of existence. It was by way of trial which our great grandfather Adam alayhi salatu wassalam and our great grandmother Hawa, it was by way of the trial of eviction from paradise that creation of man, beginning of existence, commenced. When Allah evicted them from paradise, it was in His wisdom so that creation could start on the surface of the earth, so that you and I could be. Also, Allah says to us, "Asa antakra'u shay'a wa huwa khayrul lakum wa asa an tuhibbu shay'a wa huwa sharrul lakum wallahu ya'lamu wa antum la ta'lamun." It may be that you find yourself in a situation which you detest, وَهُوَ خَيْرُ لَكُمْ, but Allah knows that it is best for you. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا, and sometimes you find yourself in a situation which you love, وَهُوَ شَرُّ لَكُمْ, but it is bad for you. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Only your Creator knows that which is good for you and that which is bad for you. So whenever a believer would be going through belief, he would have at the back of his mind that Allah is trying to see where I belong, in the categories of real believers or in the categories of those who only claim to believe. Let us also remember that all the prophets of Allah, may Allah be pleased with them, whenever Allah will subject them to trial, He will put on their tongue what to say to come out of that trial. Prophet Noah alayhi salatu wassalam, otherwise known as Noah, when he was consumed by the whale beneath three layers of ocean in the belly of the fish, Allah put on his tongue, "La ilaha illa anta subhanaka Inni kuntu min adh-dhalimin. This is what he was saying. Like we did. Our grandfather Adam, alayhi salatu wassalam, when they were evicted from Jannah, what were they saying? Rabbana, dhulamna anfusana, wa illam taghfirilana wa tarhamna, lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Upon this, Allah forgave them and gave them joy. And in the Quran, we find many dua that Allah has said that when we find ourselves in difficulty, even before we find ourselves in difficulties, we say this dua. Part of them, Rabbana la tu'akhidina in nasina aw akhtana. Oh Allah, do not take us to task if we forget or we fall into error. Rabbana wala tahmil alayna isran kama hamaltahu ala alladhina min qablina. Oh Allah, do not subject us to the kind of trial that you subjected those who came before us to. Why? Because we know that we do not have the level of iman to be able to cope with this kind of trial. Rabbana wala tuhammilna ma la taqata lana bi wa'fu anna waghfir lana warhamna anta maulana fansurna 'ala al-qawmil kafirin. Oh Allah, do not impose on us any more burden than we have the ability to cope with, than we have the capacity to cope with. Allah has taught us this dua. They are genuine dua, and I urge each and every one of us to make a habit of saying this dua. May Allah save us from trial, little and small, and whenever He will bring them, may He give us the tawfiq, the wherewithal, to be able to cope with them, and to be able to overcome them, and to be able to renew our faith in Allah. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi al akhyar wa sallama tasliman kathira. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Habibi, halal habibi, 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 halal habibi.